What a beautiful day to be alive. It's so lovely out right now. And gosh, we've just been having all this sunshine and the air's crisp and cool. And oh, it's just lovely out. I cherish this. You know, I'm celebrating my life every day in newfound ways. I've never felt this good in my entire life that I can recall ever. I mean, and not to say I didn't have good times, you know, and enjoyed, you know, periods in my life where, you know, I had all sorts of, you know, thrills and chills and spills. But it was always masked somehow. And it all started with early on with my introduction to addictive properties. And I'd have to say that sugar was my very first addictive, that I just couldn't get enough sugar as a kid. And then later it was, you know, salt. And then it became cigarettes and then alcohol, every kind of drug you can take. Hard work, hard play. I mean, I really had a zeal and a gusto for life. But I also had massive injuries along the way due to several different circumstances. And as these injuries built up, a catalog was being developed, a file. My body was taking notes. And with each occasion, it got worse. So the worse it got, the worse I felt. And so how can I fix this? How can I correct this? Well, the easiest things to do was to continue my addictions. So I drank more, I smoked more, I ate more, and I pretended everything was okay. I lived in a perfect state of denial. I pushed my body to the point of breaking. I played Superman, like nothing could stop me. And I did this my whole life. I did. And the price of that admission is pretty high. I was realizing, you know, only in these last couple years, that what I was doing is slowly, painfully, poisoning myself to an early grave. And that's all I was doing. I wasn't doing anything to improve my life. Every day I was continuously poisoning myself slowly and waiting to die. Now, to finally come to face-to-face with that reality and really recognizing that something has gone wrong, you know, that was a big, big turnaround for me. And so, first it was vegan. That was my first change. When I went vegan, I started to shift at that point because I really started having this huge empathy. And it started filling one hole, just one, but it was a significant hole that I had in my beingness, in my heart, in my consciousness. And it soon to follow was the alcohol and the cigarettes. And then as I started getting, I was really good at food, you see. I was a professional. I had talent and skills, and everybody loved me because I fed their faces. You know, I was always, everybody would put up with me, literally. And that's the way I see it. They just put up with me because I could make some tasty meals. And then, oh, wasn't I the great guy? Wasn't I the hero? Oh, you know, applause, applause. But once I pulled out of all that, everything changed. It all changed. You know, it's like nobody cared, you know. They don't want to know anything now. And I mean, they don't want to know anything. And so there's a lot of letting go to love myself, to respect myself, to honor myself. And when I say these things to myself, I hope you're looking into the mirror, because I am you. I just chose not to live in denial anymore. I decided I would start seeing if I could find another side of life, if I could actually become something that I could never fathom. I couldn't even imagine myself being healthy. I couldn't imagine it. I had no concept of it my entire life. You know, even in the, you know, the last decades and stuff, I'd look at vegans and, you know, yoga people and, you know, and I'd go, God, how do they, you know, blah, blah. My mind would just like, never get it. I wouldn't get it. And that was a part of my defense mechanism and my denial. So how did it serve me? It didn't. It just perpetuated me prolonging my life with poisoning on a daily ritual. So now I've reached a new threshold, and urine therapy has changed everything. On my health level, it's completely changed. I am a completely, completely physically a different person than I was even 4 months ago. Completely. And every day now, I celebrate. I look at my life as a brand new adventure. I really do feel like a kid. I'm regaining my sensibility. I'm regaining my enthusiasm and my ambition and my hope that I actually have a future. Yeah, and not just a past. But this is what keeps me in the present. And this is no easy task. It's simple, but it's not easy. And most people are not willing, I know I was one, to give up their position, work so hard for this position, for this place in my life, in this, you know, this person that I think I am, all the while living in denial about what's really so. And how miserable you really are. How physically, you know, you don't want to admit to yourself or your family or friends, you know, that you're a mess. I know. My sense of denial was huge. But I'm not in denial about anything anymore. I'm just telling the truth. And I've learned how to totally love myself in ways that I never thought imaginable. And my body at this point, all my chronic illnesses, all my chronic aches and pains, all my disease, all of my illness, gone. 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 4 months. Gone. And now, here I am, drinking aged urine. My own private stock. And rubbing it into my body on a daily basis. I do it every morning. It's now become a ritual before I do anything. Pardon me. And now I'm fasting. This is day five. And I feel great. I'm understanding how powerful I am. I'm learning that with my pee and my breath, my attitude, my perspective, my commitment, discipline, my authenticity and my genuine approach to really, sincerely changing myself, from the habit, you know, addicted, poisoned person that I was in the past. I'm letting go of that person. It's just somebody I used to know. And a lot of people don't even want to touch this. They don't want to even know who I have become at this point. It scares them. I know it. It scares them. They don't want to talk to me. They don't want to know anything. And that's okay. You know, hey, I lived in denial my whole life. My whole life. But I'm just not going to live in denial anymore. I'm not going to do it. So I'm just encouraging you. If you are looking at your life and your life doesn't look the way you want it to, change it. You can do it. There's nobody else that can change it but you. Only you have the power to change you. And I am you. You know, we're all in this together. You know, we are teachers and we are students. And we pass it along, just mentoring each other, learning how to do life in a better way, reaching a higher consciousness. If I can do it, you can do it too. Believe me. You know, I never, ever imagined I would be sitting here drinking aged stock and talking to you about perfect health. That was the furthest thing from my mind forever. But in 4 months' time, I can honestly sit here, sincerely tell you that I, on this day, am in the best health I've ever been in my entire life. And I will drink to that. Now, with all that being said, I'm going to share a poem with you. And this is entitled, Love's Everlasting. Imagine a lamp at your beck and call, granting a wish, any wish at all. What would you wish for? What would it be? Something you purchase or something that's free? Do you ever dream of someone that serves you with respect and love you deserve? Is love so elusive that it just causes pain, with emotional turmoil that drives you insane? Is it a sentence God's placed on your life to torture your soul with each roll of the dice? God doesn't play that. It's all up to us. God is pure love, and it's a matter of trust. If we feel empty and scarcity rules, God is abundant with spiritual tools. Know them and own them, affirm them with pride. Love's everlasting with God on your side. And so there it is. So with all that being said, I wish you well. I hope you have a beautiful, wonderful, marvelous day. Peace to you all. And boom! Ah, you've just been loved.